from me. Say next.
It's getting closer.
You should have thought of it before. I can give them this. Just the watch. Then they can leave and I can stay in the hand.
You can't do that!
If they want the doctor, they can have him.
He'll never let you do it.
And if they get what they want, then...
Then it all ends in destruction. I never go to the end. Those creatures would live forever. To breed and conquer. The war across the stars. For every child. Martha. Timothy. Would you leave us alone, please?
He won't love you.
If he's not you, then I don't want him to. I had one husband and he died. And I never thought ever again. And then, so.
It looks real. Really?
Never seen. Blasted thing. Blasted thing. Can't even hear it. It's nothing to me. What are you going to do?
We'll blast them into dust, then fuse the dust into glass, then shatter them all over again!
Just stop the bombardment. That's all I'm asking. I'll do anything you want. Just stop.
Say please.
Please.
Wait a minute. Still human.
No, I can't pretend to understand. Not for a second, but I want you to know I'm innocent in all this. He made me, John Smith. It's not like I had any control over it.
He didn't just make himself human. He made himself an idiot.
Same thing, isn't it?
I don't care about this doctor and your family. I just want you to go. My strength has increased. So I've made my choice. You can have him. Just take it, please, take him away.
Last.
Don't think that saved your life.
Family of mine. Now we shall have the lives of a Time Lord.
It's empty.
Where's it gone?
You tell me. Oh, I think the explanation might be you've been fooled by a simple olfactory misdirection. A little bit like ventriloquism of the nose. It's an elementary trick in certain parts of the galaxy, but it has got to be said. I don't like the look of that hydrochronometer. It seems to be indicating you've got energy feedback all the way through the retro stabilizers feeding back into the primary heat converters. Or, because if there's one thing you shouldn't have done, you shouldn't have let me press all those buttons. But, in fairness, I will give you one word of advice. Run. Get out! Get out!
He never raised his voice. That was the worst thing. The fury of the Time Lord. And then we discovered why. Why this Doctor, who had fought with gods and demons, why he'd run away from us and hidden. He was being kind. He wrapped my father in unbreakable chains forged in the heart of a dwarf star. Tricked my mother into the event horizon of a collapsing galaxy to be imprisoned there forever. He still visits my sister once a year, every year. I wonder if one day he might forgive her, but there she is, can you see? He trapped her inside a mirror, every mirror. If ever you look at your reflection and see something move behind you just for a second, that's her. That's always her. As for me, I was suspended in time, and the Doctor put me to work standing over the fields of England as their protector. We wanted to live forever, so the Doctor made sure that we did.
Is it done?
It's done.
Police and the army are at the school. Parents have come to take the boys home. I should go. They'll have so many questions. I'm not sure what to say. Oh. You look the same. Goodness, you must forgive my rudeness. I find it difficult to look at you. Doctor. Call you Doctor. Where is he? John Smith?
He's in here somewhere.
Like a story. Could you change back?
Yes.
Will you?
No.
I see. Well then. He was braver than you. In the end, that ordinary man, you chose to change. He chose to die.
Come with me.
Sorry.
Travel with me.
It's what?
My companion.
But that's not fair. What must I look like to you, Doctor? I must seem so very small.
We could start again. I'd like that. You and me.
We could try at least.
Because everything that John Smith is and was, I'm capable of that too.
I can't.
Please come with me.
I can't.
Why not?
John Smith is dead. And you look like him.
He's here. Inside. If you look in my eyes.
Answer me this. Just one question. That's all. If the Doctor never visited us, never chosen this place, would anyone hear it?
bene. Molto bene.
How was she?
Time and moved on.
If you want, I could go and...
Time and moved on.
Meant to say, back there last night, I would have said anything to get you to change.
Oh, yeah, of course you would. Yeah.
I mean, I wasn't really...
No, no, no.
Good.
Fine.
So there we are then.
There we are then, yeah. And I never said... Thanks for looking after me.
Doctor. Martha.
Tim Doothy Timber.
I just wanted to say goodbye. And thank you. Because I've seen the future and I now know what must be done. It's coming, isn't it? The biggest war ever.
You don't have to fight.
I think we do.
We could get hurt.
Well, so could you, traveling around with him, but it's not going to stop you.
Tim, I'd be honored if you'd take this.
I can't hear anything.
No, it's just a watch now. But keep it with you. For good luck.
Look after yourself.
You like this bit.
In June 1914, an Archduke of Austria was shot by a Serbian. And this then led through nations having treaties with nations, like a line of dominoes falling. Some boys from England walking together in France on a terrible day.
1 minute past the hour. It's now. Hutchinson, this is the time. It's now. To the right!
Good luck. Don't even blink. Blink and you're dead. They are fast. Faster than you can believe. Don't turn your back. Don't look away. And don't blink. No.
I don't have enough spirit. It is not ready yet.
Hello? Bit freak needs to talk. Make you a coffee.
Sally Sparrow, it's 1 in the morning. I think I'm going around at 1 in the morning.
No?
I'm in the kitchen. Was there one of those screens in your front room?
Oh, God. Sally, you've met my brother Larry, haven't you?
No. You're about to.
Okay. Not sure. Really hoping.
He's not getting the chance.
Pants?
No. Put them on! I hate you! What are you thinking? Sorry, my useless brother. Sally, what's wrong? What's happened?
Okay, let's investigate. You and me, girl investigators. Wait. Hey,
Sparrow and Nightingale.
That so works.
At ITV.
I know.
I love old things. They make me feel sad.
What's good about sad?
It's happy for deep people. The weeping angel.
Not that in my garden.
It's new.
It's what?
Since yesterday. I'm sure of it. It's closer. It's got closer to the house.
How can my name be written here? How is that possible?
Be a burglar.
A burglar who rings the doorbell.
Okay. I'll stay here in case of.
Case of.
Incidents.
Okay.
I'm looking for Sally Sparrow.
How did you know I'd be here?
I was told to bring this letter on this date at this exact time to Sally Sparrow.
Looks old.
It is old. I'm sorry, do you have anything with a photograph on it, like a driving license? I suppose. Funny feeling after all these years.
Who's it from?
Oh, that's a long story, actually.
Give me a name.
Catherine Wainwright. But she specified I should tell you that prior to marriage, she was called Kathy Nightingale.
Kathy?
Kathy. Yes. Catherine Costello Nightingale.
Is this a joke?
Joke?
Kathy, is this you? Very funny. Kathy?
You need to take this. I promised.
Excuse me. Where am I? I was in London. I was in the middle of London.
You're in Hull.
No, I'm not.
This is Hull.
No, it isn't.
You're in Hull.
I'm not in Hull. Stop saying Hull. Who are you? Why are you here?
I made a promise.
Who to?
My grandmother. Catherine Costello Nightingale.
Don't have that in London. There's no call for it. It's all Hull.
1920. Your grandmother?
Yes. She died 20 years ago.
So they're related?
Sorry?
My Cathy, your grandmother, they're practically identical.
Where are you going?
My dearest Sally Sparrow, if my grandson has done as he promises he will, then as you read these words, it has been mere minutes since we last spoke. For you. For me, it has been over 60 years. The third of the photographs is of my children. The youngest is Sally. I named her after you, of course. This is sick. This is totally sick. Kathy! 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 Unless I live to a really exceptional old age, I will be long gone as you read this. Don't feel sorry for me. I have led a good and full life. I've loved a good man and been well loved in return. You would have liked Ben. He was the very first person I met in 1920.
Are you following me?
Yeah.
You're going to stop following me?
No, I don't think so.
To take one breath in 2007 and the next in 1920 is a strange way to start a new life. A new life is exactly what I've always wanted. 1902. You told him you were 18, you lying cow. My mum and dad had gone by your time, so really there's only Lawrence to tell. He works at the DVD store on Queen Street. I don't know what you're going to say to him, but I know you'll think of something.
I don't have enough spirit.
Just tell him I love him.
Excuse me, I'm looking for Lawrence Nightingale.
With a bat.
Hello?
Sorry.
Quite possibly.
Oh.
Afraid so.
Oh. Hello. Can you help me?
Hi.
38?
Just a moment.
Yeah, I kind of muted my mic. I didn't realize.
We've met, haven't we?
It'll come to you.
Yeah, I know I can change the stats.
Oh my god.
Sorry, I almost crashed. Or the game crashed. And I almost died
message
again.
Message from your sister.
Oh, okay.
I'm trying this magic part now.
What is it?
I'm not sure if it's working.
She's had to go away for a bit.
Where?
Just a work thing. Nothing to worry about.
Okay.
And
what?
She loves you.
She what?
She said to say, she just mentioned it.
Maybe it just only works
nice,
if you have 300.
Is she ill?
No, no.
Am I ill?
No.
Is this a trick?
No. She loves you.
I know I should change the stats.
People
and stuff,
don't understand time.
It's just a crap, everything.
Who's this guy?
Sorry, the pause thing keeps slipping. Stupid thing.
Last night at Kathy's, you had him on all those screens, that same guy.
First.
Talking about. I don't know, blinking or something.
Yeah, the bit about the blinking's great. I was just checking to see if they were all the same.
What were the same? What is this? Who is he?
An Easter egg.
Excuse me?
Like a DVD extra, yeah? You know how on DVDs they put extras, you know, documentaries and stuff? Well, sometimes they put on hidden ones, and they call them Easter eggs. You have to go looking for them, follow a bunch of clues in the menu screen.
Complicated.
Sorry. It's interesting, actually. He is on 17 different DVDs. There are 17 totally unrelated DVDs all with him on. Always hidden away, always a secret. Not even the publishers know how he got there. I've talked to the manufacturers, right? They don't even know. He's like, he's a ghost DVD extra. Just shows up where he's not supposed to be. But only on those. Those 17.
Well, what does he do?
Just sits there, making random remarks. It's like half a conversation. Me and the guys always trying to work out the other half.
When you say you and the guys, you mean the internet.
Sakamitsu and Roku.
How do you know?
Spooky, isn't it?
Very complicated.
Lawrence! Ninja!
Excuse me a sec.
People assume that time is a strict progression of cause to effect, but actually, from a non-linear, non-subjective viewpoint, it's more like a big ball of wibbly-wobbly, timey-wimey stuff.
Started well, that sentence.
It got away from me, yeah.
Okay, that was weird. Like, you can hear me.
Well, I can hear you.
Okay, that's enough. I've had enough now. I've had a long day, and I've had bloody enough! Sorry. Bad day.
I hear the list.
What?
The 17 DVDs. I thought you might be interested.
Yeah, great. Thanks.
Go to the police, you stupid woman! Why does nobody ever just go to the police?
Look, I know how mad I'm sounding.
Shall we try it from the beginning this time?
Okay, there's this house. A big old house, been empty for years. Falling apart. West of Drumlins, out by the estate. You've probably seen it.
West of Drummond.
Yes.
Good night.
Could you just wait here?
Zero. Tack for it off. Look in me. Yeah, shit. So good.
The
AI Billy Shipton, Wester Drumlins, that's mine. Can't talk to you now, got a thing I can't be late for. So if you could just...
Hello?
Hello?
Marcy, can you tell them I'm going to be late for that thing?
Burps of love.
All of them?
Over the last 2 years, yeah. They all still had personal items in them, and the couple still had the motor running.
So for the last 2 years, the owners of all of these vehicles have driven up to Wester Drumlin's house, parked outside, and just disappeared. What's that?
Ah, the pride of the Wester Drumlin's collection. We found that there too. Somebody's idea of a joke, I suppose.
But what is it? What's a police box?
Well, it's a special kind of phone box for policemen. They used to have them all over, but this isn't a real one. The phone's just a dummy and the windows are the wrong size. Can't even get in it. Ordinary airlock, but nothing fits. But that's not the big question. See, you're missing the big question.
Okay, what's the big question?
Will you have a drink with me?
I'm sorry.
Drink? You? Me? Now?
Are you on duty, Detective Inspector Shipton?
Nope. Knocked off before I left. Told them I had a family crisis.
Why?
Because life is short and you are hot. Drink?
No.
Ever?
Maybe.
Phone number?
Moving kind of fast, D.I. Shipton.
Billy, I'm off duty.
Aren't you just?
Is that your phone number?
Just my phone number. Not a promise, not a guarantee, not an IOU. Just a phone number.
And that's Sally...
Sally Shipton. Sparrow! Sally Sparrow. Keep going now, don't look at me.
I'll phone you.
Don't look at me.
Phone you tomorrow.
Don't look at me.
Might even phone you tonight.
Don't look at me.
Definitely gonna phone you, gorgeous girl.
Definitely Sparrow.
But nothing fits.
Welcome.
Where am I?
1969. Not bad as it goes. You've got the moon landing to look forward to.
Oh, the moon landing's brilliant. We went 4 times. Back when we had transport.
Working on it.
How did I get here?
Same way we did. Touch of an angel. Same one, probably, since you ended up in the same year. No. Don't get up. Time travel out of capsule. Nasty. Catch your breath. Don't go swimming for half an hour.
I can't.
Fascinating race, the Weeping Angels. The only psychopaths in the universe to kill you nicely. No mess, no fuss, they just zap you into the past and let you live to death. The rest of your life used up and blown away in the blink of an eye. You die in the past, and in the present they consume the energy of all the days you might have had. All your stolen moments. They're creatures of the abstract, they live off potential energy.
What in God's name are you talking about?
Trust me, just nod when he stops for breath.
Track you down with this. This is my timey-wimey detector. Goes ding when there's stuff. Also, it can boil an egg at 30 paces. Whether you want it to or not, actually, so I've learned to stay away from hens. It's not pretty when they blow.
I don't understand. Where am I?
It's 1969, like he says.
Normally, I'd offer you a lift home, but somebody nicked my motor. So I need you to take a message to Sally Sparrow. And I'm sorry, Billy. I am very, very sorry. It's gonna take you a while.
Hello? Billy, where are you? Where?
Hello?
Billy?
Raining when we met.
It's the same rain.
I need spirit.
She looks nice.
Her name was Sally, too.
Sally Shipton.
Sally Shipton. I often thought about looking for you before tonight. Apparently, it would have torn a hole in the fabric of space and time and destroyed two-thirds of the universe. Also, I'd lost my hair.
Two-thirds of the universe, where'd you get that from?
There's a man in 1969. He sent me with a message for you.
What man?
The doctor.
And what was the message?
Just this. Look at the list.
What does that mean? Is that it? Look at the list.
He said you'd have it by now. A list of 17 DVDs. I didn't stay a policeman back then. Got into publishing. Then video publishing. Then DVDs, of course.
You put the Easter egg on.
Have you noticed what all 17 DVDs have in common yet? I suppose it's hard for you, in a way.
How could the doctor have even known I had a list? I only just got this.
I asked him how, but he said he couldn't tell me. He said you'd understand it one day. Or that I never would.
As soon as I understand it, I'll come and tell you.
No, gorgeous girl. You can't. There's only tonight. You told me all those years ago that we'll only meet again, this one time. On the night I die.
Oh, Billy.
It's kept me going. I don't have enough spirit. I'm an old sick man. But I've had something to look forward to. Life is long, and you are hard. Look at my hands. They're all man's hands. How did that happen?
I'll stay. I'm gonna stay with you, okay?
Thank you, Sally Sparrow. I have till the rain stops.
They're mine.
What?
The DVDs on the list, 17 DVDs. What they've got in common is me. They're all the DVDs I own. The Easter egg was intended for me.
You've only got 17 DVDs.
Do you have a portable DVD player?
Gosh, why?
I want you to meet me.
Where?
West of Drumlins.
You live in Scooby-Doo's house.
For God's sake, I don't live here.
Okay.
is the one with the clearest sound. Slightly better picture quality on this one, but I don't
know. Doesn't matter.
Okay. There he is.
I am returning to town.
The doctor.
Who's the doctor?
He's the doctor.
Yep, that's me.
Okay, that was scary.
No, it sounds like he's replying, but he always says that.
Yes, I do.
And that?
Yep. And this?
He can hear us. Oh my God, you can really hear us.
Of course he can't hear us. Look. I've got a transcript, see? Everything he says. Yep, that's me. Yes, I do. Yep, and this. Next, it's...
Are you going to read that whole thing?
Sorry.
Who are you?
I'm a time traveller. Or I was. I'm stuck. In 1969.
We're stuck. All of space and time he promised me. Now I've got a job in a shop. I've got to support him.
Martha.
Sorry.
I've seen this bit before.
Quite possibly.
1969, that's where you're talking from?
Afraid so.
But you're replying to me. You can't know exactly what I'm going to say 40 years before I say it.
38?
I'm getting this down. I'm writing in your bits.
How? How is this possible? Tell me.
Not so fast.
Yeah, people don't understand time. It's not what you think it is.
Then what is it?
Complicated.
Tell me.
Very complicated.
I'm clever and I'm listening. And don't patronise me because people have died and I'm not happy. Tell me.
People assume that time is a strict progression of cause to effect, but actually, from a non-linear, non-subjective viewpoint, it's more like a big ball of wibbly-wobbly, timey-wimey stuff.
Yeah, I've seen this bit before. You said that sentence got away from you.
It got away from me, yeah.
Next thing you're gonna say is, well, I can hear you.
Well, I can hear you.
This isn't possible.
No, it's brilliant.
Well, not hear you exactly, but I know everything you're gonna say.
Always give me the shivers, I bet.
How can you know what I'm going to say?
Look to your left.
What does he mean by look to your left? I've written tons about that on the forums. I think it's a political statement.
He means you. What are you doing?
I'm writing in your bits. That way I've got a complete transcript of the whole conversation. Wait until this hits the net. This will explode the egg forums.
I've got a copy of the finished transcript. It's on my autocue.
How can you have a copy of the finished transcript? It's still being written.
I told you, I'm a time traveller. I got it in the future.
Okay, let me get my head around this. You're reading aloud from a transcript of a conversation you're still having.
Wibbly-wobbly, timey-wimey.
Actually, never mind that. You can do shorthand.
So?
What matters is we can communicate. We've got big problems now. They have taken the blue box, haven't they? The angels have the phone box.
The angels have the phone box. That's my favourite. I've got that on a T-shirt.
What do you mean, angels? You mean those statue things?
Creatures from another world.
But they're just statues.
Only when you see them.
What does that mean?
Lonely assassins, they used to be called. No one quite knows where they came from, but they're as old as the universe, or very nearly. And they have survived this long because they have the most perfect defense system ever evolved. They are quantum locked. They don't exist when they're being observed. The moment they are seen by any other living creature, they freeze into rock. No choice, it's a fact of their biology. In the sight of any living thing, they literally turn to stone. And you can't kill a stone. Of course, a stone can't kill you either, but then you turn your head away. Then you blink. And oh yes, it can.
Don't take your eyes off them.
That's why they cover their eyes. They're not weak, they can't risk looking at each other. Their greatest asset is their greatest curse. They can never be seen. Loneliest creatures in the universe. And I'm sorry. I am very, very sorry. It's up to you now.
What am I supposed to do?
The blue box, it's my time machine. There is a world of time energy in there they could feast on forever, but the damage they could do could switch off the sun. You have got to send it back to me.
How? How?
My force gained strength.
And that's it, I'm afraid. There's no more from you on the transcript. That's the last I've got. I don't know what stopped you talking, but I can guess. They're coming. The angels are coming for you, but listen. Your life could depend on this. Don't blink. Don't even blink. Blink and you're dead. They are fast, faster than you could believe. Don't turn your back. Don't look away and don't blink. Good luck.
No! Don't! You can't!
I'll rewind him.
What good would that do? You're not looking at the statue.
Neither are you.
Keep looking at it. Keep looking at it.
This one, we're okay. If we just keep staring at this one statue, everything's gonna be fine.
There's three more.
Three?
They were upstairs before, but I think I heard them moving.
Moving where? Three of them moving where?
I'm gonna look around. I'm gonna check. You keep looking at this one. Don't blink. Remember what he said. Don't even blink.
Who blinks? I'm too scared to blink.
Okay, we're going to the door. Front door. Okay, we can't both get to the front door without taking our eyes off that thing, so you stay here.
What?
I'll be just around the corner. You stay here. They've locked it! They locked us in!
Why?
I've got something they want.
What?
A key! I took the last time I was here and they followed me to get it back. I led them to the blue box. Now they've got that.
Give them the key!
I'm gonna check the back door. You wait here.
Give them the key! Give them what they want!
So long as I can see. Our world at the box, the doctor says. I hope he's not lying, because I don't see how else we're getting out. Oh, and there's your one.
Why is it pointing at the... light.
Oh my god, it's turning out the light!
Quick, me!
I can't find the lock!
This is Security Protocol 712. This time capsule has detected the presence of an authorized control disk. Valid one journey. Please insert the disk and prepare for departure.
Looks like a DVD player. There's a slot.
I don't think we need to.
Feel the
He tricked them. The doctor tricked them. They're looking at each other. They're never gonna move again. Can you mind the shop? I'm just nipping next door for some milk.
Yeah, no worries.
What's this? Sally, can't you let it go?
Of course I can't let it go.
This is over.
How did the doctor know where to write those words in the wall? How could he get a copy of the transcript? Where did he get all that information from?
Look, some things you never find out, and that's okay.
No, it isn't.
Everything. This might be getting in the way of other things.
We just run a shop together. That's all it is, just a shop.
Anyway. Milk. Back in a moment. What has not happened?
No, Doctor, please, 20 minutes to red hatching.
It was me. Oh, for God's sake, it was me all along. You got it all from me.
Got what?
Okay, listen. One day you're going to get stuck in 1969. Make sure you've got this with you. You're going to need it.
Doctor!
Yeah, listen, listen. Gotta dash. Things happening. Well, four things. Well, four things and a lizard.
Okay, no worries. On you go. See you around someday.
What was your name?
Sally Sparrow.
Good to meet you, Sally Sparrow.
Across the stars, over and over again, come to Utopia.
Doctor?
Captain?
It's a future time!
Utopia is...
the last of the humans scattered across the night.
Humans are coming.
Not even the Time Lords came this far. We should leave.
built on a rift in time and space. Just like California and the San Andreas Fault. But the rift bleeds energy. Every now and then I need to open up the engines, soak up the energy, and use it as fuel.
So it's a pit stop?
Exactly. Should only take 20 seconds.
The rift's been active.
Wait a minute. They had an earthquake in Cardiff a couple of years ago. Was that you?
Bit of trouble with the Sladeen.
Long time ago.
Lifetimes. I was a different man by then.
Doctor! Let me go. All powered up. Into the future, near 1 billion, 5 billion, 5 trillion, 50 trillion, what? The year 100 trillion, that's impossible.
What happens then?
We're going to the end of the universe.
Surface. Another human hunt. God help him.
Should I alert the guards, though?
No, we can't spare them. Well, Bevan's on his own. One more lost soul dreaming of utopia.
John, you mustn't talk as though you've given up, though.
No, indeed. Here's to it. Utopia. Well, it is to be hoped the coffee is a little less sour. Will you join me?
Chan, I am happy drinking my own internal milk, though.
Yes, well, that's quite enough information, thank you.
Professor Yana, don't want to rush you, but how are we doing?
Yes, working, yes, almost there.
How's it looking on the footprint?
It's good, yes, fine, excellent.
Chan, there's no problem as such. We've accelerated the calculation matrix, but it's going to take time to harmonize, though. Chan, we're trying a new reversal process. We'll have a definite result in approximately 2 hours, though. Professor, though!
Yes, working.
Chan, it's the surface scanner, Professor. It seems to be detecting a different signal, though.
Well, that's not a standard reading. I can't make it out. It would seem something new has arrived.
Oh, we've landed.
So what's out there?
I don't know.
Say that again, that's rare.
Not even the Time Lords came this far. We should leave. We should go. We should really, really... go.
Thank you.
time you've got that medical kit there.
Hello again. Oh, I'm sorry.
Here we go. Get out of the way. It's a bit odd, though. Not very 100 trillion. That coat's more like World War II.
I think he came with us.
How do you mean, from Earth?
Must have been clinging to the outside of the TARDIS. All the way through the vortex. Wow, that's very him.
What, do you know him?
A friend of mine. Used to travel with me. Back in the old days.
But he's... I'm sorry, there's no heartbeat. There's nothing. He's dead. It's all right, breathe deep, I've got you.
Captain Jack Harkness. And who are you?
Martha Jones.
Nice to meet you, Martha Jones.
Oh, don't stop.
I was only saying hello.
Doctor?
Captain?
Good to see you.
And you? Same as ever.
Hello. Have you had work done? You can talk.
Oh, yes, the face. Regeneration. How did you know this was me?
The police box kind of gives it away. I've been following you for a long time. You abandoned me.
Did I? Busy life, moving on.
Just gotta ask. The Battle of Canary Wharf. I saw the list of the dead. It said Rose Tyler.
Oh, no, sorry. She's alive.
You're kidding.
Parallel world, safe and sound. And Mickey, and her mother.
Oh, yes!
Good old Rose.
So there I was, stranded in the year 200-100, ankle deep in Dalek dust, and he goes off without me. But I had this. I used to be a time agent. It's called a vortex manipulator. He's not the only one who can time travel.
Oh, excuse me, that is not time travel. Like, I've got a sports car, you've got a space hopper.
Oh, boys and their toys.
All right, so I bounced. I thought 21st century, the best place to find the doctor, except I got it a little wrong. Arrived in 1869, this thing burnt out, so it was useless.
Told you.
I had to live through the entire 20th century waiting for a version of you that would coincide with me.
But that makes you more than 100 years old.
And looking good, don't you think? So, I went to the time rift, based myself there, because I knew you'd come back to refuel. Until finally, I get a signal on this detecting you, and here we are.
But the thing is, how come you left him behind, Doctor?
I was busy.
Is that what happens, though? Seriously? You just get bored of us one day and disappear?
Not if you're blonde.
Oh, she was blonde! Oh, what a surprise!
You two, we're at the end of the universe, right? Right at the edge of knowledge itself, and you're busy... blogging! Come on.
Is that a city?
City or a hive, or a nest, or a conglomeration? Like it was grown. But look, there, it's like pathways, roads. Must have been some sort of life. Long ago.
What killed it?
Time. Just time. Everything's dying now. All the great civilizations have gone. This isn't just night. All the stars have burned up and faded away. Into nothing.
They must have an atmospheric shell. We should be frozen to death.
Well, Martha and I, maybe. Not so sure about you, Jack.
What about the people? Does no one survive?
I suppose. We have to hope. Life will find a way.
Well, he's not doing too bad.
Is it me, or does that look like a hunt? Come on!
There's more of them. We've got to keep going.
I've got a ship nearby. It's safe. It's not far. It's over there.
moving on.
We're close to the silo. If we get to the silo, then we're safe.
Silo?
Silo.
The silo for me.
Go back to where you came from. I said, go back, back!
Oh, don't tell him to put his gun down.
He's not my responsibility.
And I am? That makes a change.
Can do I see you? I'm hungry. Yeah!
Right, let's get you inside.
My name is Padre Fetchevko. Tell me, just tell me, can you take me to Utopia?
Oh, yes, sir. Yes, I can.
Professor, we've got four new humans inside. One of them is calling himself a doctor.
Of medicine?
He says of everything.
What? A scientist? Oh, my word. Oh, I don't know. I'm coming!
It's like a box. A big blue box. I'm sorry, but I really need it back. It's stuck out there.
I'm sorry, but my family were heading for the silo. Did they get here? My mother is Kistane Shavekay. My brother's name is Belton.
Computers are down, but you can check the paperwork. Creep, passenger needs help.
Right, what you need?
A blue box, you said. Big, tall, wooden. Says police.
We're driving out for the last water collection. I'll see what I can do.
Thank you.
Come on. Sorry, but how old are you? Old enough to work. This way. Kistane Shavekay. Kistane and Belton Shavekay. I'm looking for Kistane and Belton Shavekay.
The Shavekays, anyone?
Anyone?
Kistane from Red Falls Fire.
Kistane and Belton Shavekay. Chef Kane family. Anyone called Chef Kane?
It's like a refugee camp.
Stinking.
Oh, sorry. No offense, no.
Don't you see though? The ripe old smell of humans. You survived.
Oh. Might have spent a million years evolving into clouds of gas. Had another million as download, but you always revert to the same basic shape. The fundamental humans.
Kissing, Chef.
End of the universe, and here you are. Indomitable, that's the word. Indomitable!
Ha! Is that Kistane Shavekay?
That's me.
Oh my god. Oh, no bad news.
Captain Jack Harkness, and who are you?
Stop it. Get his hand with it. It's half deadlocked. See if you can overwrite the code.
Let's find out where we are.
Gotcha.
Thanks.
How did you cope without me?
Now that is what I call a rocket.
They're not refugees, they're passengers.
He said they were going to Utopia.
The perfect place. 100 trillion years, a single dream.
You recognize that, don't you?
No. Whatever it is, it's not rocket science. But it's hot, though.
Willing.
But if the universe is falling apart, what does Utopia mean?
The doctor, that's me.
Good!
It's good, apparently.
Jan, welcome, though.
This is the gravitational accelerator. It's partially...
Jan, welcome, though.
And over here is the footprint impeller system. Now, if you know anything about end-time gravity...
Hello?
Have you?
A little bit.
Chanto, though.
But we can't get it to harmonize.
Captain Jack Harkness.
Stop it.
Can I say hello to anyone?
Chan, I do not protest, though.
Maybe later, Blue. So what do we got here?
And all this feeds into the rocket.
Yeah, except without a stable footprint, you see, we'll never achieve escape velocity. If only we could harmonize the five impact patterns and unify them, well, we might yet make it. But what do you think, Doctor? Any ideas?
Well, basically, sort of, not a clue.
Nothing?
I'm not from around these parts. I've never seen a system like it. Sorry.
No, I'm sorry. It's my fault. There's been so little help.
Oh, my God! You've got a hand. A hand in a jar. A hand in jar in your bag.
That's my hand.
I said I had a doctor detector.
Chan, is this a tradition amongst your people, though?
Not on my street. What do you mean that's your hand? You've got both your hands. I can see them.
Long story. I lost my hand. Christmas Day. It was all fine.
What, you grew another hand?
Yeah.
Hello.
Yeah, might I ask, what species are you? Time Lord. Last of. Heard of them? Legend or anything? Not even a myth? Blimey, end of the universe is a bit humbling.
Tan, it is said that I am the last of my species too, though.
Sorry, what was your name?
You're my assistant. And good friend, Chantho. A survivor of the Malmuth. This was their planet, Malcacero, before we took refuge.
The city outside, that was yours.
Chan, the conglomeration died, though.
Conglomeration? That's what I said.
You're supposed to say sorry.
Oh, yes. Sorry.
Chan, most grateful, though. You grew another hand. Hello again.
It's fine. No, really, it's me.
All this time and you're still so surprised. Chan, you are most unusual.
So what about those things outside, the Beastie Boys? What are they?
We call them the future kind, which is a myth in itself, but it's feared they are what we will become. Unless we reach Utopia.
And Utopia is?
Oh, every human knows Utopia. Where have you been?
Bit of a hermit. A hermit? With friends.
Hermits United. We meet up every 10 years, swap stories about caves. It's good fun for a hermit. So, Utopia?
The call came from across the stars, over and over again. Come to Utopia, originating from that point.
Where is that?
Oh, it's far beyond the condensed wilderness. Out toward the wild lands and the dark matted reefs, calling us in. The last of the humans scattered across the night.
Why do you think so?
We can't know. A colony, Pacific, some sort of haven. The Science Foundation created the Utopia Project thousands of years ago to preserve mankind, to find a way of surviving beyond the collapse of reality itself. And perhaps they found it. Perhaps not. But it's worth a look, don't you think?
Oh, yes. And the signal keeps modulating, so it's not an automatic. That's a good sign, something out there.
Professor.
Right, that's enough talk. There's work to do. Now, if you could leave.
Thank you. You all right?
Yes, I'm fine. And busy.
Except that rocket's not gonna fly, is it? This footprint mechanism thing is not working.
We'll find a way.
You're stuck on this planet.
And you haven't told them, have you? That lot out there, they still think they're gonna fly.
Well, it's better to let them live in hope.
Quite right, too. And I must say, Professor, what was it?
Yarn.
Professor Yarner, this new science is well beyond me. But all the same, a boost reversal circuit in any time frame must be a circuit which reverses the boost. So I wonder what would happen if I did this.
It's working, though.
But how did you do
we've been chatting away, I've got to tell you, I'm brilliant.
What's your name? Crete.
That's right, miss.
Who are you with, Crete? You got family?
No, miss. There's just me.
Well, good luck. What do you think it's going to be like in Utopia?
My mum used to say the skies are made of diamonds.
Good for her. Go on, off you go. Get your seat.
An extract binds the neutralino map together.
That's food. You built this system out of food and string and staples. Professor Yarlett, you're a genius.
Yeah, says the man who made it work.
Oh, it's easy coming in at the end, but you're stellar. This is magnificent. And I don't often say that because of me.
Well, even my title is an affectation. There hasn't been such a thing as a university for over 1,000 years. I've spent my life going from one refugee ship to another.
If you'd been born in a different time, you'd be revered. I mean it. Throughout the galaxies.
All those damn galaxies. They had to go and collapse.
Some admiration would have been nice. Yeah.
Just a little, just once.
Well, you know it now. But that footprint engine thing, you can't activate it from on board. It's got to be done from here. You're staying behind.
With Chancel. She won't leave without me. She simply refuses.
You'd give your life so they could fly.
Oh, I think I'm a little too old for Utopia. Time I had some sleep.
Professor, tell the doctor we found his blue box.
Ah! Doctor?
Professor, it's a wild stab in the dark, but I might just have found your way out.
I'm fine. Just get on with it.
Here, connect those circuits into the spa same as the last slide. But quicker.
Yes, sir.
You don't have to keep working. We can handle it.
Mr. Saturday, it's just this noise inside my head, Doctor. Constant noise inside my head.
What sort of noise?
It's the sound of drones. More and more, as though it's getting closer.
When did it start?
I've had it all my life. Every waking hour. Still, no rest for the wicked.
So, how long have you been with the professor?
Jan, 17 years, Doc.
Blimey, long time.
Jan, I adore him, Doc.
All right, and please.
Jan, I don't think he even notices, Doc.
Tell me about it.
Jan, but I am happy to serve, Doc.
Do you mind if I ask? Do you have to start your sentence with Chan?
Well, Chan, yes, Doc.
And end every sentence with
Chan, Doc, Doc.
What would happen if you didn't?
Chan, that would be rude, Doc.
Your recruit has left.
What, like swearing?
My foes lose some of their strength.
Chan, indeed, Doc.
Go on, just once.
Chan, I can't, Doc.
Oh, do it for me.
No.
Professor.
Systems are down.
Professor, are you getting me?
I'm here, we're ready.
Now all you need to do is connect the couplings. Then we can launch. Don't see this equipment. Needs rebooting all the time.
Anything I could do, I'll finish that lot.
Yes, if you could. Just press the reboot key every time the picture goes.
Certainly, sir. Just don't ask me to do shorthand.
Are you still there?
Ah, present and correct. Send your man inside.
We'll keep the levels down from here.
Keep the dials below the red.
Where is that room?
It's underneath the rocket. Fix the couplings and the footprint can work. But the entire chamber is flooded with STET radiation.
STET?
Well, we wouldn't want to. But it's safe enough. We can hold the radiation back from here.
Flat.
Jack, override the vents!
Get out! Get out of there! Jake! Are you? Go!
We can jumpstart the override.
The chamber's flooded with radiation, yes?
Without the couplings, the engine will never start. It was all for nothing.
Oh, I don't know.
Martha, leave him.
You've got to let me try.
Come on, come on, just listen to me. Now, leave him alone. Strikes me, Professor, you've got a room which no man can enter without dying. Is that correct?
Yes.
Well... I think I've got just the man.
Was someone kissing me?
Get aboard the rocket! I promise I'm gonna fly!
The chamber's bloody jet!
Trust me, we found a way of tripping the system. Run! What are you taking your clothes off for?
I'm going in.
Well, by the looks of it, I'd say the STET radiation doesn't affect clothing, only flesh.
Well,
I look good, though. How long have you known?
Ever since I ran away from you. Good luck.
We lost picture when that thing flared up. Doctor, are you there?
Receiving, yeah. He's inside.
And still alive?
Oh, yes.
He should evaporate. What sort of a man is he?
I've only just met him. The doctor sort of travels through time and space and picks people up. God, I make us sound like stray dogs. Maybe we are.
He travels in time.
Don't ask me to explain it. That's a TARDIS, that box thing. The sports car of time travel, he says.
When did you realize?
Earth, 1892. Got on a fight in Ellis Island. Man shot me through the heart. Then I woke up. Thought it was kind of strange. But then it never stopped. Fell off a cliff, trampled by horses, World War I, World War II, poison, starvation, a stray javelin.
Ooh.
In the end, I got the message. I'm the man who can never die. And all that time you knew.
That's why I left you behind. It's not easy, even just... just looking at you, Jack, because you're wrong.
Thanks.
You are, I can't help it. I'm a Time Lord, it's instinct. It's in my guts. You're a fixed point in time and space, you're a fact. That's never meant to happen. Even the TARDIS reacted against you, tried to shake you off. Flew all the way to the end of the universe just to get rid of him.
So what you're saying is you're, prejudiced?
I never thought of it like that.
Shame on you.
Yeah.
Last thing I remember, back when I was mortal, I was facing three Daleks.
It's Daleks.
Death by extermination.
It's Daleks.
And then I came back to life. What happened?
Rose.
I thought you'd send her back home.
She came back. Opened the heart of the TARDIS and absorbed the time vortex itself.
What does that mean exactly?
No one's ever meant to have that power.
If a Time Lord did that, he'd become a god, a vengeful god. Look, she was human.
I bring life.
Everything she did was so human.
She brought you back to life.
But she couldn't control it, she brought you back forever. That's something, I suppose. The final act of the Time War was life.
Do you think she could chase me back?
I took the power out of her.
She's gone, Jack. She's not just living on a parallel world, she's trapped there. The walls have closed.
I'm sorry.
Yeah.
I went back to her estate in the 90s. Just once or twice. Watched her growing up. Never said hello. No, timelines and all that.
Do you want to die?
Oh, this one's a little stuck.
Jack.
I must try this. I thought I did. I don't know. But this lot, you see them out here surviving. And that's fantastic.
You might be out there somewhere.
I could go meet myself.
Well, the only man you're ever going to be happy with.
This new regeneration. It's kind of cheeky. Regeneration. Regeneration.
I never understand half the things he's saying. What's wrong? Tom, Professor, what is it, though?
There's time travel. They say there was time travel back in the old days. I never believe. But what would I know? Stupid old man. Never could keep time. Always late, always lost. Even this thing never worked.
Martha, this watch is me. I'm gonna become human.
Time and time and time again. Always running out on me.
Can I have a look at that?
Oh, it's only an old relic. Like me.
Where did you get it?
I was found with it.
What do you mean?
An orphan in the storm. I was a naked child found on the coast of the Silver Devastation. Abandoned with only this.
Have you ever opened it?
Why would I? It's broken.
How do you know it's broken if you've never opened it?
It's stuck. It's old. It's not meant to be. I don't know. Does it matter?
No. It's nothing. It's... Listen, everything's fine up here. I'm gonna see if the doctor needs me.
Now, get out of there, come on!
Initiate.
Ah! Nearly there! The footprint, it's a gravity pulse. It stamps down the rocket shoots up. Bit primitive. It'll take the both of us to keep it stable.
Doctor, it's the Professor. He's got this watch. He's got a fob watch. It's the same as yours. Same writing on it. Same everything.
Don't be ridiculous.
I asked him. He said he's had it his whole life.
So he's got the same watch.
Yeah, but it's not a watch. It's this chameleon thing.
No. It's this thing, this device. It rewrites biology. Changes a time lord into a human.
And it's the same watch.
Can't be.
That means it could be a time lord. You might not be the last one.
Jack, keep another one.
That's brilliant, isn't it?
Yes, of course it is. Then switch one. Brilliant, fantastic, yeah. But they died, the time lords. All of them, they died.
Not if he was human.
What did he say, Martha? What did he say?
He looked at the watch like he could hide.